Hey, welcome. So I just tried to do this scope. Hello, Cheryl. Hey, Cheryl, I just seen your scope, girl. That was so cute. That recipe card. I love that idea, honey. So, everybody, welcome. Thanks for joining me. My name is Shantae Tutt. Hello. Oh, I do not want to mess up your name, Vin. Please give me your name. Let me know where you're from. Thanks for joining me, all my newbies. Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to give you all a little quick tip and tutorial on how to use this color wheel to help you with your crafts. Cheryl, do me a quick favor and just say hello real quick. Oh, there you go. Thank you. I just wanted to make sure my connection was good. I just tried to do this scope and it didn't turn out well. I had to delete it. Now I'm doing it all over again. You couldn't hear me or anything. Hey, loves to love Scrappy. I just have to say that every time she comes to my room, I love her name. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So for you who just joined, I'm about to give you a quick tip on how to use this, incorporate this into your crafts, into your craft world. So if you have any questions during this, just let me know, ask real quick. Hello, Cheryl, real quick. If you have any crafty friends, please share this scope. Let them know, let them in on what's happening in the craft world, in my craft world. And if you enjoy anything during this scope, please show your love and give me hearts. All you got to do for the newbies who don't know is tap on the screen. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. All right, y'all. So here's the color wheel. Y'all remember this from school? Ooh. So this is how I use it. This is a great tool for when you're crafting. Don't worry if you have comments or questions. Even though I'm standing up and going to the side, I can still see when you enter the scope and if you have any comments or questions for me. Please, I love it when people participate. So if you have any questions, let me know. Okay, so let's get started. So here's the color wheel. Some people call it the color circle. I call it the color wheel. So this is a great tool for when you're scrapbooking or making cards or any kind of crafts, especially if you're a painter. So right here, let's start with the color red. So if you didn't know, right here in the center of the color wheel, let's start with red. And right here you see it says complementary color. So if you're working with the color red, okay, you just want to do something real quick. You don't want it to be real intricate or anything like that. Then you know that, okay, you scroll down or look down here, you see that that's green is the complementary color. So that's the color you want to use on your craft. You know that when you use those two colors together, that's what's going to catch your customer's or client eye or the person you're gifting your craft to or anything like that. You know that's the color that goes best with the color red. Okay, and then just to take it a little further, you have split complementary colors. So the way you find out that is, so we're working with the color red right now. So right here in the center, it says split complementary color. So you're going to look and you're going to know that the split complementary color. Oh, I have it upside down, you guys. You got to turn it. Bear with me. Okay, so you turn it around. You want the arrow pointing red. Okay, so now you know that for red, you have blue green and yellow green right here are the two colors that's going to work best with red. If you want to start getting a little bit more intricate with your project and incorporate more than just one or two colors. So you know those three colors, what are the colors that'll work best and be more or most appealing to the eye, okay? And then it even goes further and further in depth and right here in the center. And they have the definitions on the side, so if you're lost to that, when you get your color wheel, they will have the definitions. Now, let's go to here on the side. It says tint, tone, and shade. If you don't know, hello, thanks for joining, Rose. Welcome. I think you're a newbie to my scope. Thank you for joining. So we're discussing the color wheel. So right here on the color wheel, you see it says tint, tone, and shade. Hello, everybody. Welcome Rose to the room. Oh, she's a sweetheart. Thanks for giving me the hearts, honey. I'm glad to have you here this evening. So right here you have red, and right here it tells you, so when you're doing working with tint, you guys, I don't know if you know this already, but for tint it means adding white to the color. So adding white to red. Tone means adding gray, and shade means adding black. So if you were to add white, you would get this pinkish color here. If you were to add the color gray, you'll get this grayish tone here. And if you were to add black, you'll get this darker shade. And that's how you work with the tint, tone, and shade. So if you're a painter or working with markers or watercolors, things like that, and you just move it around, and then you can get this information for each color here on the color wheel. Now, Rose, I know you just entered. I already went over the complementary colors and the split complementary colors, what works best with the color red. And now I'm going to go ahead and flip it over here to this side, you guys. A lot of people don't use this side, y'all, but this is also helpful because a lot of people, sometimes we forget. Doesn't mean, it's nothing wrong with that, but we forget which colors are considered the warm colors and the cool colors. So if you forget that, you can always go to your little trusty color wheel here, and it'll tell you. So all the cool colors are over here to the center, and then from here all the way down here to the center are the warm colors. And then also on this side, it shows you what you get if you add, let's start with the letter, the color red again. If you add the color blue to red, this is the color you're gonna get. I think that's so cool. I hope you all can see this well. So let's see. If you add the color white to red, then of course, we all know this, you're gonna get the color pink. And then if you add the color black to red, it's this burgundy type color here. So that's how you use this side. A lot of people neglect this side, but this is how you use this side. And I'll even go to yellow and show you all how that works. So if you add black to yellow, you get this cool green color. If you add white to yellow, you get this color, and so on and so on. So again, just to recap, if you're working on a scrapbooking layout or card and you're like, oh, I want to jazz it up a little bit, get a little funky, then you're probably not going to want to go to using the complementary color. Okay? You don't want it to look too basic. You want to get a little crazy with it. You want to go to the split complementary color. So let's take blue, just for any newbies. And instead of going to the complementary color for blue, which is orange, we're going to go to the split complementary. I have it upside down. Bear with me. Okay. So instead of going to orange, we're going to go to red orange and yellow orange, just to add a little dimension to our project and to jazz it up a little bit and spice it up. If you want to go and add a little extra spice to it, you can go over here to the triad section, and it's going to tell you to use red with it or yellow with it. So that's going to give you a more bold looking project. So that was my little, just a little quick tutorial on the color wheel, you guys. You all have any questions? You still with me, loves to love, scrapping, scrapping. Cheryl's World, are y'all still with me? Do you have any comments? Let me check my notes real quick and see, did I miss anything? I went over what tints, tones, and shades were. Now, I'm not an expert. I got these a few years ago, basically just for the complimentary and stuff. It's a whole bunch of more you can do with these, but that's basically what I use it for. So I hope that helped you guys. No one has any questions for me? Remember to share with your followers. No questions? All right, you guys. Check back in with me tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to do a craft scope tomorrow and actually show you all a craft I'm working on, or just give you another tip on how to use a certain tool. I don't know which tool yet. If you have a specific tool you don't know how to use and then I have it, just go ahead and comment. Let me know if I have the tool. I'll do the scope on that tomorrow, but let me know. I try to do a scope every day. Thanks for joining me. Everyone, have a good night.